world, we have Paul Lavers and a Doctor Who special. Stay tuned.
Fantastic. Thanks very much to everyone who put that one together. Nice to have your company. The last time I had that theme music was a long time ago. A man who sort of made almost a bit of a life quest. Bob Stevenson, nice to have you in the studio. You've brought us a fantastic collection. When did you first get into Doctor Who?
It was only about 4 years ago.
Only 4 years ago?
Yeah, I made a construction kit of a Dalek. It reminded me of how I was so frightened, but at the same time felt safe at being at home. And it went on from there. And I just started finding different bits and pieces and that. And
Well, featuring heavily, of course, are the Daleks, yeah, which are featuring in today's show as well. I mean, they were sort of, I mean, they're a precursor of all the sort of science fiction villains.
Mind your language!
Oh, sorry, beg your pardon. I didn't want to upset our very own. Now, is this the friendly Dalek?
No, do not upset the Daleks, supreme masters of the universe!
He's very good. The trouble is, what worries me is he's been speaking like that even when he's out of it, which is a bit of a worry.
Only when I'm in the pub!
But this is actually the full size, isn't it? That's the full size Dalek. Yeah. I'm not sure quite what Freud would say about this. Or Victor Lewis Smith, for that matter. And you've got these fabulous, you've got the TARDIS, you've got the Daleks, a box set, you've got the videos, of course.
There's everything, bubble baths.
I notice you haven't got the androids of Tara for episode set, but
I forgot to bring that one.
No, never mind, it's all right, don't worry. I'll give you my own copy. You've got Davros, of course.
Davros, the supreme being!
Yeah, so just behave, otherwise I'll get Davros onto you, all right? He used to be a personal friend of mine.
I saw that episode.
So just be careful. There he is, look. There's Davros. And of course, if you're not careful, I shall bring the master on.
Not Watley.
No, not Watley. Not Watley.
Anything but Watley.
actually, that would be a terrific threat, wouldn't it, to the Daleks? Watley. Well, Watley, you Daleks.
We surrender immediately.
Oh, I don't know. Bob, I tell you what, I think you've landed on a very strange planet.
Why?
I tell you, one of the chances to get over your phobia of the Dalek, if you always hid behind the couch to watch Doctor Who, or then join the club, there are so many people like that who did.
We hide behind the sofa from you, Lavers!
I certainly wouldn't get behind the sofa with you, because you wouldn't know what would start.
You should be so lucky!
Actually, okay, a little quiz. Who provided the initial voices of the Daleks?
We did.
No, you didn't. Come on. Come on, clever clogs. Who was the man who provided the voices?
Cannot compute.
Cannot compute.
Must consult Davros.
Well, in other words, if you actually also watched Captain Pugwash, you'd probably know. Because it was an actor called Peter Hawkins. The same guy who used to provide all the voices for Captain Pugwash actually was the voice of the Daleks for about 8 years before there were anybody else's voices used. It was all Peter Hawkins.
I was in the Groucho Club with him last week.
Whose idea was it? Leslie, can we cut it now? Can we wheel him off? Because I was, you know, it was a good idea when we thought about it, but now you think about it, you know. £29, just because he's coming out with the funny lines, that's why I don't like him. Well, listen, Bob, can I just say thank you for coming
on? Thank you very much for having me.
And hopefully we'll bring you back, or maybe come over to you to film your whole collection.
With this annoying character.
Yeah, this one, yeah, this annoying character. Well, the nice thing is he can't go upstairs, that's the only thing.
I'm in a bungalow!
Don't you look at me like that. I'll disconnect you if you're not careful. Yeah, no answer to that, have you? No.
Economy 7.
Typical. Economy 7, that's just like my mother cooks on. There's a little click in the night and she's off. Off like the wind. So will you be if you're not careful.
Anything as long as I don't have to eat your cooking, Lavers.
Actually, apparently it's rumoured that my cooking put him there in the first place. But there's only one Tom Baker. If you've seen him in Medics, another terrific portrayal. And he's on a lot of the radio players on Radio 4. Get the book, personally signed, £29.40. Post and packaging of just £1.90. It's 101221. Looks like the master got himself into the works just then and flashed up the wrong details.
Exterminate him!
Yes, exterminate him, why not? I tell you what, yes. It's overgrown canine. Why don't you get yourself working and get rid of all the bugs in this place?
It would take too many years!
Well, get about it, set about it. Typical of you, you old bag of electronic bits and pieces.
Oh, you bitch!
You're allowed to say that at this time of day. I'll tell you what we've got now. It's Tom Baker. From the mind of Tom Baker, it's the boy who kicked pigs. I don't know whether I've got any measure. Gus, well done. You've got the long... Well, fantastic. Thank you very much, Gus. So let's have a quick... Actually, it's more. It's actually a... Sorry, was I disturbing you?
No, I was just watching you.
What, watching me measure?
I want the key to the TARDIS.
Yeah, well, you can't have it. It's not available to Daleks.
It is priceless, Obscuro.
Yes, it is, I know, but you're not going to have it. It's 30... The actual chain is 26 inches. So that wouldn't even get round your fat neck, I'm afraid. So you're stuck, I'm afraid. You will not get it.
On the diet?
You'd have to go on a pretty crash diet, I can tell you. Yeah, no more silicon chips for you. Okay. It's enough. It's enough of that. So if you want the key to the TARDIS, then you can get one for just £19.90, post and packaging of £1.80. It's 101224. Limited edition. Real collector's item. I love this. Welcome to the wonderful world of Doctor Who. And of course, it wouldn't be the wonderful world of Doctor Who without his, sort of, I suppose, his most favourite nemesis. What was the episode? Do you remember when there was a friendly Dalek? It was a bit like there's been a friendly cyborg, Borg on Star Trek. There was actually a friendly Dalek.
That must have been a defect.
It was. I mean, that's what the Daleks thought it was. Actually, in actual fact, the Daleks were really the Borg, weren't they? Because they were like a sort of symbiotic relationship between all Daleks. Do you understand the word symbiotic? No, of course you don't. That's typical of you. You haven't plugged into your main power supply recently, have you?
No.
Good for you. But what I've got next, take a look. We've got this wonderful, this is the Louis Marks. I'm going to take up my chair here so you can see it in contrast with our huge Dalek here. Exterminate!
Come to Daddy!
Come to Daddy. Oh, hang on, go back that one. It's wonderful, look.
I think I'm going to cry.
It's a bit like Alien with Sigourney Weaver, isn't it, really? Oh. No. Oopsie. No, come back.
He is escaping from you, Lavers.
No, he likes me more than he does you, I think.
He wants to get away and come to me.
There he goes. Oh. Filming the androids of Tara, and everybody always used to talk about if you ever see me outside and they say, oh, we hear you were in Doctor Who, did you play a Dalek? I've heard it 500 times. Everybody always says, if you say you were in Doctor Who, they say, oh, you played a Dalek, did you? Yeah, yeah. And you laugh, you, yeah. Yeah. Sorry?
I was just making myself comfortable.
I thought you were trying to make... Well, would you mind not doing that in here? would you wait until after the show's over before you do that?
Yes.
Thank you. Oh, okay then. Don't let a Dalek get near it either. Because otherwise they'll grab it.
It will be mine, Davis.
They'll take it back to their home planet. And Davros will... put it in a special ray and turn it full size.
My dad?
And again, yeah, your dad, how is he?
Not bad!
He wasn't looking too good the last time he was on air. £38.70, post and packaging at £3.20. That's really great. Now, come on, Dalek. You must know. Search your memory banks. What series was William Gaunt absolutely wonderful in?
He was in the series The Champions in your Earth years, 1960s.
He was, of course. And who was his co-star?
A man and a woman.
You don't know Alexandra Bastido? Oh, what a shame. What a snivelling failure. Forgets the name of Alexandra Bastido, one of the biggest personalities of the... She was a wonderful, lovely actress. That was The Champions, of course. Really a treat for all Doctor Who fans, and more particularly for Dalek fans, because I think there are probably more Dalek fans than there actually are Doctor Who fans. They're just one of the villains.
All fans of you!
Well, definitely more Dalek fans than there are fans of me.
We are better looking!
Well, I think you are. You've got better motion anyway. That's better motion control. And you've got shapelier legs as well.
I'm waiting for a caster replacement!
I'm waiting... Yeah, actually, were you on the caster couch then? Okay.
Wait for it, Lavers!
K9. Which was, I suppose, when you listen to the voice... If you remember the voice of K9? It wasn't that far away from the voice of the Daleks. And I think it was the best of the Daleks in terms of something that you could actually love.
That's an insult!
Well, I think it's a compliment, you see, my little tin-headed friend. I think it's quite a compliment to say that the Daleks were so popular they had to bring on something that would actually rival your popularity. So they thought of K9.
This way, Master!
Very good! Very good. Now, John Leeson, who played the voice of K9, was a terribly erudite guy, very, very intelligent guy. And as I said, he always used to be at the rehearsal rooms doing the Times crossword. And I believe it was in episodes that Bob Baker and Dave Martin wrote that first saw the appearance of K9. And I believe that K9's trademark and copyright is not actually owned by the BBC. It's actually owned by Dave Martin and Bob Baker. So there you go, my little tin helmeted friend.
That's very interesting.
That's something you didn't know, I bet. There you are. You see, you live and learn when you're on the planet Ideal World.
Hello. How are you?
The Doctor is in here.
Yes, I think he's somewhere around.
I can hear you!
Yes. No, don't worry. I'm coming in on the Gallifrey Express.
It's quite interesting, isn't it? Yeah, thank you. For £35.50, you can get the whole three of them. K9, you can get Tom Baker as Doctor Who, and of course you can get our erstwhile knobbly tin friend, otherwise known as the Dalek.
Mind your language, Lavers!
I was being complimentary, you buffoon. And it was the limited edition replica Louis Marks Bump and Go Dalek. £38.70, post and packaging at £3.20. 101225 for our gold. There was a whole hierarchy, wasn't there, about what colours? The black Dalek, the red Dalek?
Yes.
The gold Dalek? Which one were you? Oh, you're the dirty grey Dalek.
I'm just a drone.
Yes, just a drone, so get on and drone. You're supposed to just here to do the work. You're supposed to be sweeping up now, it's the end of the hour. Well, thanks very much to my grey friend here. Thanks very much, our Dalek.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you for having me.
That's quite all right. We must have you back on again.
I would love to come.
We must also say a big thanks to Bob Stevenson. Thanks very much for all his wonderful creations that we've got, and of course that wonderful collection. And hopefully we'll be inviting you to take another trip with us on the TARDIS with my little grey friend and me and everybody else. Don't go far away. Thanks for being with us on Ideal World. It's the On Air Club next.